Hello there everyone, welcome to iOS filmmaking. Today I'm going to show you how to add music to your videos. And we're going to do this using iMovie running on my iPad mini, although it will work equally as well on your iPhone. So let's get started by opening up iMovie by clicking on the icon. And then let's go to the project that we wish to add the music to. In this case, it's My Movie. Let's click on that. And then let's click on Edit. So here we are in the main timeline window. And you can see I have some clips already in there. So let's click on the little sound icon to see what the sound waves are doing. So there we go. We can see that there is already sound associated with these clips. So let's just go and have a listen to that sound and hear what that sounds like. So it's pretty horrible stuff. Actually, it's what we call Atmos sound. It's the sound of the people and the crowd that was actually there when I filmed these clips. So now let's go and find the piece of music that we wish to add to this to these clips. So let's click on the plus icon up here to go to the media browser and then click on audio and let's search by artists. Now because this is a London scene, I think we should use the band called London Grammar. Click on them. And I've got a few tracks of theirs in the cloud, but if I was to try and download one of those, it would take a few minutes. I've already got one here. It's called Metal and Dust, so let's use that one. So it's going to start by giving us a preview, just to give us an idea of what the sound, the music sounds like, and to hear if it's appropriate or not. I think it is, so let's stop that and click Use. And as you can see, it brings it down into the timeline already. And because we have the sound wave icon illuminated, it also gives us the sound wave. So it starts off fairly quietly and then it gets a bit more lively towards the end. So let's hear what all of that sounds like together. So it's pretty awful still. We can't hear the music track. And that's basically because the sound of the Atmos is way too loud. It's drowning out the sound of the music. So we can turn that down by clicking on the clip, clicking on volume at this little menu down the bottom here, and then using the slider, slide the audio down to zero. And as you can see, as I did that, the sound wave decreased to zero. So let's try that again. You can see it's going down. Let's click on the third clip, decrease it. Click on the last clip and it's gone. We haven't lost that audio. That audio is still there. It's just it's at a zero level, so we won't be able to hear it. So let's just click on the timeline and hear what that sounds like. So that's much nicer. Now it sounds quite good as it is. But if we wanted to bring it to life a little bit, what we could do is reintroduce some of that Atmos audio. So let's go back to our first clip, highlight it, and as before, the audio was at zero, and let's just try bringing it up a little bit. Let's try 3%. So we're there at 3%, and let's just hear what that sounds like. Now for some reason, when you do that, iMovie reduces the volume of the music track underneath. So let's just bring that up a bit more. Bring it up to there. Let's be careful at the end here. You can see we've got some louder peaks. We don't want it too high because that might start distorting. So let's hear what that sounds like. So that sounds a bit better. And let's introduce the Atmos back to each of the other tracks. Let's just go 3%, 3%, 3%, and 3%. Oops, 3%. And 3%. Oops, a bit fiddly. 3%. So let's just quickly hear what that sounds like all together. It's sounding quite nice. It sounds like it's got some kind of atmos there along with the music. And here we are coming up to one of the crucial bits now where it starts to get a bit louder. Okay, now I think that's still a little quiet, so let's just up that a bit more. And we're at one of the louder bits and hear what that sounds like. A life on trust, though it starts with love and lust. So that's pretty good. So now what we can do, we can highlight the music. And if we want to trim the clip, we can do so now as well. So just as you can shorten or lengthen the video clips, you can shorten and lengthen the music that you put underneath it. And here we are back in the, we've highlighted the clip by touching it, and we're back in the sound setting. And as you can see, the clip is now highlighted, and we can pick up this handle and we can bring it back. So the music now will end before the end of the video. So let's just show that. But as you can hear, it ends quite suddenly. So what we can also do, we can create a fade. So let's highlight the clip again. Let's bring it up and let's extend it back again. We're on the trim mode of this setting, but let's just click fade here to enter the fade setting, and that yellow trim handle has now turned into a triangle, and what you're actually affecting is the volume of that clip. So where that clip will be the end here, that will be zero, and when you drag the little triangle back, that's where it starts fading out. So let's hear what that sounds like. So that's much, much nicer. So there we go. That's how to add music to your edit. If you have any questions about that, please leave a comment. But in the meantime, thank you very much for watching. Please like and share and check out some of my other films.